गुड मॉर्निंग. तो स्टार्ट नाउ. ठीक है, सो वेयर वी स्टॉप यस्टरडे. हेलो हेलो, आर यू लिसनिंग?
या यस सर, मोहिदीन.
सो वेयर वी स्टॉप यस्टरडे?
या वी वर डिस्कसिंग रिगार्डिंग दैट कंपोजिट थिंग. देन आई थिंक यू स्टार्ट विद द फंक्शंस.
ओके, so what is function? That is what we have to see today. So function is nothing, function is just a concept, and again as we seen in Python, everything is an object, function also an object, and here it is a concept. So what is the concept? So what it's going to do, let's we talk about. So it is nothing but a block of code. Okay, so till now we wrote some set of codes, we wrote a block, we wrote like a conditional statement for etc, right? So the purpose is we supposed to execute something. We are actually play with some object, and we are actually producing some result depends on our input. Got it? So, but if you want to repeat the similar logic or the same logic with the other input or the same thing in some other location, what we have to do? We need to copy the exact line. We need to paste it once again. We need to execute it. This is what we have to maintain. Got it? So say for example, if you want to find a len for a two names I'm having, let's say example. So okay, so here what I have to do, so without using len function, we have to create our own. Okay, what shall I do? Okay, len is nothing but a function, you all know that, but hereafter you need to think about the logic behind the function. You need to think about the logic behind each and every function. Got it? So try to replicate how len will be there. So how len was constructed or created. So what will be the logic behind the len? Okay, so I'm having a name. Name one is there. And the name two, I need to find len for both. Okay, what shall I do? So can someone summarize the logic, what it might be, what it would be? So what is how we can find out the length? It is just normal mathematics, a basic mathematics. We all know string is iterable, a normal mathematics. Anyone? I just need a length of this name. So how will you calculate the length as a human? How will you calculate it?
Missing.
One by one.
One by one. That is, you need to count, right? So it is P1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. It's 8. So I want to be done in programmatically. What to do? Just, I said Python is something similar with what we actually are seeing in a day-to-day life, right? So just try to solve it in a math, and we will convert it into Python code. In normal math, what will you do? Similarly, just try to replicate in Python. So at the end, what we need? First derive what we need at the end. What we need at the end?
Number of letters in that word.
Number, right? That is, we can call it as out, anything.
Right.
So what it be? So initially, what shall I declare?
Zero.
Zero. And then?
For.
For.
For. In name one.
Name one. Colon. Next. And then what you need to do for each time. So you are getting each time. So each time what to do? Each time what you need to do?
It will retrieve the pardon? Each character.
Pardon?
We need to increment the out.
Out. That's it. So we don't need to use this right. we don't need this character at all. But for each iteration, we supposed to increase this count. That is out, out equal to out plus one. We can do or plus or equal to. So and we might seen in math, that is plus or equal. Both will work. Got it? Now the answer is 8. So if we want to do this, so this is the logic was reside in len function. If I say len of name on, you will get the same thing. Got it? Now we understand how, what is function, how they created the function. So this is what we have implemented without using any function. Got it? This is what function does. We are actually getting the same output. Understand?
Is there a way to see the code behind the standard functions?
You mean a built-in, right?
Yeah, the built-in.
Yes, we can do that. So, if you want to be in a script, there is a built-in function, right? Okay. So, I will show you from IDE. So, here is my IDE. Here I'm saying len. Got it? So in this is a feature in IDE, the feature which is available in IDE. So what you have to do, you just say control click. Okay, it will be take you to the corresponding code. So we can able to see the complete code. So we have all the buildings. So we will find the code for all the buildings. And still we can see from so. Built-in, I will I got a message from office. So here it is. So you can use the PyCharm, so or any editor. So if you are using an editor, so it contains the possibilities. So it will actually bring you to that corresponding code. So you have to just click and move on. And otherwise, there is a function. Sorry, the package from inspect input get source. But for the here, it is not actually showing the code. So it is not showing, but this is the way to explore. Let's say, for example, if it is a random, and if you want to check the code for random, just say random, you'll get the complete code of for random. But for built-in, it's not showing. I don't know what it is. But the feature is available in IDEs or editor. So you can use IDE or editor to explore the corresponding code. Got it? So for function from the package, I will tell you. So, but this is the package, get import random get source. But for len, it is not working. I will check and let you know. Okay. But you can get through using some IDEs. So IDE will help you to redirect into that. Got it? I will tell you that in details. So now we have replicated the logic behind len function, right? So this is this is a logic behind len. So you need to declare some output that is zero, and you need to iterate your iterable object, and for each iteration we supposed to increment the output. Okay, finally just return the result. That's it. This is how len was built. If you want to do the if you want to find this same len for a name too, what you have to do, you need to apply the same logic, out is equal to zero for something in your name to say out equal to one. Okay, so we'll get the count. So what happened here, my code was repeated n number of times, so up to my needs. Okay, this is purely unwanted, so we can sort out with the help of function. So I will convert this into function. So we'll call it as a len. This is my object, and I'm going to say out equal to zero for something in your object out less or equal to one, and finally you have to say return. That's it. So this is my function. Now something similar with len is a built-in, and len is a function which we created. So if you say name one, you will get an answer. Similarly, len also will give you an output. Got it? So if you have some list, you'll get it. Got it? So this is the reason why we're creating a function. The purpose is reusability, to reduce redundant code, to avoid ambiguity. So it will avoid the redundant code. Got it? Why we're using function, and what is function? So are you clear with ideas? What is function? Got it? So have you get it? What is a function and why are you using function? Any idea or any doubts in this? Any doubts in this? Any doubts? Shall we proceed? Come on, next topic. Hello?
Yes, please.
Yeah. Okay, now we are going to talk about the categories of functions. Okay, so functions are mainly categorized into two. I mean the available function. One is user defined, one is a built-in function. That is a predefined and user defined. So this is the categorization. So what is user defined? What is built-in? Let's talk about that. So built-ins. So we have used so many built-ins till now. Okay. Why we using built-in, and what is the purpose of built-in? So we might have some set of needs, like now we found a length, and sometimes we are doing type conversion. Yesterday we have used iter, and we have used a range to generate a range of numbers. So this is the frequent usage. For that, Python come up with a predefined solution, that is built-in function. Okay, because these are the concepts which people are using frequently. So they have derived these requirements before itself. So we don't need to reconstruct once again. That is called built-in. Okay, so built-in function is nothing but pre-written function. That's it. Okay, and if you want something else, we have to write it ourselves. So we need to create our own function if we have a dedicated needs or something else. And if you want something else, we need to construct something on top of it. Just create your own function. That is called predefined function. Okay, so it is categorized into two types. So two types of function. One is built in or predefined functions, and the second thing is user defined functions. Okay, and in both the cases the syntax is similar. That is def, a function name, and open close parenthesis followed by colon, and then what it is. Don't say this is a reserved keyword. I'm talking about what it contains, what it should contain. If you clearly understand, you will answer.
It will skip the
no, I'm not block. Talking about, that is what I said. I'm not talking about what is passed. I'm saying what this part contains. So we are actually talking about block of code, exactly. So def is a reserved keyword to create a function, and a function name, open close parenthesis, colon, followed by block of code. So this is what you have created, your logic. You need to place your logic inside. This is the syntax for, this is the syntax to create a function. That's it. Okay. So both built-in and user defined was constructed in this way. In this way only. Got it? So let's move on to various functions. So we'll talk about user defined function. Before, these are the available built-in function. And if you want to find, how many built-ins are there, just say dir built-ins. This will give you the complete available built-ins which we have seen here. Okay. So here you'll find the available built-ins. So each and every error was also a function. Okay. So like a name error, everything was a function. That's it. Okay. So these are the available built-ins, so we can use it. And function also an object. So as like a variable, as like integer, as like a float, function also a kind of Python object. That's it. Okay. Now we'll talk about in detail about user-defined function. So we
sorry,
all know,
can I ask you a quick question?
Yeah, please.
There it said there was something called a debug there. What is that going to do?
So here, which one?
There is a debug.
Okay.
What does that do?
So it is not, it just giving us some boolean. It contains a true, that's it. So we can use it for a conditional purpose. Like instead of saying true, we can use it. That's it. So it just contains a value true. That's it. It just contains it's holding boolean true. That's it. It doesn't contain anything. It just contains a boolean. That's it. So if we print, we'll get it. That's it.
Thank you.
And talk. This will help you to extract the document available for a function class, etc. Let's say, for example, the dot bulletin. So, which we have seen through help. The same one. Got it? So, using this doc, so this is help is a built-in, which actually using this logic dot doc to extract the document, and it is actually showing with the help of print statement. Using a print, it is actually showing the documentation. Got it? So each and everything has its time. So we all know, just click and use it, start using it. So let's say what it is going to do and all. And all is there. Find out what is all is doing and any. What might be all or any? Any guess? All any. We have seen a similar logic in the last two classes. All any guesses? So I'm having one command.
And or
exactly. Okay. So just assume this is some user input. Okay. If all user has a true value, that is okay. If all user has a true value, means I need to perform something. For that, we need to check each and everything whether it is true or false, right? So like if true. Instead, just what you have to say, just say all. If everything is true, it will return true. Otherwise, it will return false. Got it? Or if anything is true, just we want to proceed, we just use any. Okay? So this will apply OR logic. If anything is true, it will return true. Here, if everything is true, it will return true. Or otherwise, it is false. Similarly, each and everything has it as a set time. So each and every function is going to perform some certain operation. That's it. So CHR will return a character code, and integer will convert integer. So power will return a power value. So 2 to the power of 3, you will get 8. So we all know how to implement power, right? How to?
Asterisk.
That's it. So if you want to create a function, just say power. Okay. So here, how many inputs are there? So this function requires two inputs, right? How many inputs are there?
Two
inputs. So you have to say two numbers, A comma B, or say number power. Number power. So what to do?
N asterisk B.
N asterisk P. That's it. Okay. When I say PW 3 to the power of 2, the answer is 9. Sorry, I have to say return. Got it? So, in each and every function, we supposed to maintain return if you want to return something, or otherwise you can ignore it because the default return is none. So if you don't use a return, Python Python takes a default return, that is none. If I don't say anything, what happened? So Python will take the default return, that is none. If you check whether it is equal to none, yes, it is true. Because by default Python will return none. Got it? If you don't say anything, Python will return none. So I'm checking with none. Yes, it is true. So if you don't say return, Python will apply default return. So each and every function has return block. So what is return? If you pass something, the function will throw something else. Okay? Because the block of code was executed and it generates some result, we need the result out of the block. Got it? So we all know this is the block. So we need a result out of this block, that is return going to do. So return will return the corresponding output. If you don't specify, by default Python will return none. If you want something, just use return. So return is nothing but a reserved keyword. This will works with inside a function. You won't be able to use it outside a function. It will return syntax error. As like a break continue. So return will work only inside a function. Got it? So this is a basic syntax for function. So let's move on to the various way to define a functions. Okay, so now we are talking about user-defined function inside. How many functions are there? Let's say the types of functions. By default, the functional categories into built-in and predefined. Now we are going to talk about various ways to define a function. One is name the function, and anonymous function. And then generator function. So this is what I told you in comprehension. We'll talk about what is a generator function. So let's start with the named function. So named function is nothing but a function with a name. So we can call it we can call the logic by using the specific name. That is what we have seen just before. Def a function name parenthesis colon and say your block of codes. Got it? So this is a named function. So inside a named function, so we are going to see the various way to define a named function. So this is type of function definition. And before moving on to this, and we supposed to see the blocks of a function. So block of function. So function contain two block. One is function definition, and second thing is function call. Okay. So we all know Python is a language in execution. If we say something like a is equal to 10, b is equal to 20, a plus b is producing some result, right? But if I keep the same thing inside a function, what happened? Nothing executed. The reason is this is like assigning your object into some variable. Okay, I'm saying c is equal to a plus b. What happened? This will produce a result when you're utilizing, right? So this will be calculated when you're utilizing. Till that, it will be reset as it is. Okay. So when you're utilizing, it will be performed, the calculation performed and produce a result. Similarly, when you assigning your block of code into a function name, the block of code will never execute. So that is called function definition. So this block is called function definition. It will never execute until you have to call. So you have to call using its name. Okay. So this logic was reside under this name. Got it? So this is called function definition block. Okay. And let's talk about a function call. When this logic will be executed, whenever you start to call your function. So how to call this function? Using a function name followed by parenthesis. This is the way to call your function and you will get the result. And if you assign it to variable, yes, you can. So what happened? This will execute and what returns will reside into this variable. So what function, here I'm calling the function. So you will get some result which returns. So that is a plus b, that is 30. So d contains 30. But if I say something like this, what will happen? Now what will happen? Here what will happen?
assignment
name error.
How name error? D is there, right? I have defined D. How name error?
Variable error, something like
that. No error, nothing. D is already defined. When you print, what happened? This will print function definition. S like F. So you are actually referencing what function F holds. So we have created a function F, right? So we are assigning the same thing into D. Now D will work like a function. D will act like a function. Previously, we have assigned the result into D. That is F of, right? So we have called the function. We did a function call. We are assigning function call into variable D. So what happened? This hold the result of. So this the D holds your results. Now, instead of function call, I'm assigning a function definition. So this is function definition. I'm assigning function definition to D. Now D will act like a function. Without that, D will act like so D contains some number, numeric. So if you define as like that, what happened? D will act like a function. Got the difference? So this is the basic two blocks of function. One is function definition, and second thing is function call. The block of code will be executed when you call in the function. When you calling a function. Understand? So one is function definition and function call. These are the two blocks in functions. Any doubts in this?
Bro.
Yeah.
One doubt. We defined F as the function, right?
Yeah.
So after that, we can't use F as variable name, right?
We can't use F as a variable. F itself a variable. Because function name also, I said function name is a name. It is a variable. F is a variable. The name is exists. F is an object. And it contains a code instead of a number or instead of some set of objects. But here it contains a block of code.
Mm.
And if you want to use it as a variable, just say f is equal to 1. Now f will act like a number. D will act like a function. Got the difference?
Okay, then if I write f of 0, f of means then what will be the
what will happen? You are actually overridden, right?
Mm.
What will happen? Just assume now you won't be able to call. So this is, you know, this is function call, right? This is function call. Function call is a part of function, not a part of integer. So function call is part of function object, not part of integer object. So what will be the error? What will be the error? Any guesses?
Name error.
How name error? Is it name F is not defined? Is name F is not defined?
Function not callable.
Function, it will say int object is not callable because f contains. So you are confusing f with function, but we have overrid function with number, right?
Mm.
So then it is integer is not callable. Got it? Function is callable. So if it is a function is callable, we have used, right? But if we are here, we are actually converting it into integer. Now integer is not callable, int object is not callable. I'm asking what is the error name. So what you said was error message. I'm asking what is the error message, the common message, the common term, the common error. Pardon?
Type.
What is?
Type.
Type error. Because this is related with object. So this is all about the object property. The int object is not callable means int object is restricted. So here we won't be able to make it as a callable object. So it says int object is not callable because f contains a number. So it says int object is not callable, but d will be, because d contains function reference, so it is callable. So there is a no error occur. So in when I say square brackets, I said whenever you're using some set of special characters, the corresponding property, the object should contain this relevant property, right? So similarly, whenever you're saying close bracket, the parenthesis, what happened? The object should contain the property, like say DAFT, we will see a call. This is an attribute which help you to convert your object into callable. When you say similar with if, it is not there. Call is not there. So that's why it says int object is not callable, because we don't have a property called call. This is the property which help you to make your object into callable. Understand? Any doubts? So shall we move on to function definition?
Yeah.
Now we are going to talk about a function definition. Okay. So I said this is the way to define a function. Now we are going to talk about various function definition. This is a function without argument. Function without argument. Sorry, function without parameter. So this is function without parameter, and this is function with parameter. So what is function with parameter? So we have came across string attributes and all, like dot center, what center will do, what the capitalize. Capital is an example for function without parameter. Center is example for function with parameter. Say for example, a len we did some just few moments ago. That is, say object out from the zero. Pardon? So this is an example for function with parameter. Let's see what is parameter. So parameter is nothing but the sub object inside a function, like you know that. So inside a function, I'm using some naming, right? The naming, what the naming will going to do? The naming will going to receive something, that is parameter. So parameter is nothing but a receiver which going to receive some, your user input. Okay, so parameter is nothing but a variable defined by a function that receive a value. So if you are passing something, so in a function call, say for example in a len, we are passing some input, right? If you pass something that is called argument, you are passing some argument. Okay, an object or some values which you are actually passing into a function is called argument. But similarly, in function definition, we need some definition to receive the value. We need some receiver to receive the values, right? That is called parameter. So parameter is nothing but a receiver in function definition end. Argument is nothing but the value which you are actually passing into function. So argument is nothing but a value that passes into a function. A parameter is nothing but a receiver which actually receive a value from function definition. That is a difference between parameter and argument. So now we are going to talk about, so I will replicate something. So we have all seen capitalize. So we all know capital is an example for a function without parameter, right? That is what I said. So this is because when I see a documentation, see a parameter, the parenthesis was empty, right? doesn't contain anything. Now, how it is actually works. So here we don't need to pass anything. Okay. So it will take your input and it will return as a capitalized. That's it. So what happened? This will convert your first character into capital and rest with lowercase. Got it? So how they implemented? Now, so this is actually implement inside a class. I will define with a. So this is not a built-in. I'm just creating some function with some predefined name. And then what else you need to do? So you need to replace uppercase with lowercase, okay? So we have a built-in function. So we have an attribute called is lower, is upper. So this will help us implement is lower, is upper. Okay, so what will we say? Before that, I need to make some dictionary. I'll simply replicating with four characters. I'm going to say it's some dictionary alphabet. Alpha. Here, I need some dictionary. See, if it's lowercase, we need a capital. We need upper. This is the equivalent lowercase. I'm just creating for four character. Okay. So if you want, you can implement. I'm just showing a demo. So how to. Okay. So this is upper. Similarly, I'm going to replicate for lower. In case of lower, just say capital. Got it? Now, what do you have to do? Any guesses? So input will carry your string, right? What you need to do? You need to generate some output. What to do? So what is capitalize actually doing? So capitalize, what is a capitalize actually doing?
First character will be a capital, like big character.
First character will be capital, right? Right. So now I'm going to say for INP. So here we need some enumerate because we want to convert first character into capitalized. Okay, so we supposed to do it based on an index. INDCHR character. INP upper lower. Is an example. I'll replicate this. Enumerate if index is zero, means if it is zero, you need to convert it into uppercase, right? Even it can be anything. And the next check is if it is already uppercase, leave it as it is. So we have to do another check. What you have to do? Say out equal to out plus. So we need to combine this with existing. Now here I'm going to say the logic, that is chr is upper, then leave it as it is. That is chr. Or otherwise, I need to convert it into, if it is lowercase, I need to convert into uppercase. That is, I have to pass into lower, right? Lower of my chr. Okay. So this is only an if condition. You can add it anywhere else. What happened? You all know, in after plus symbol, we need some values, right? So this online if condition will also going to return a value, right? So if matches, this will return this value, otherwise this value. So we can place it here as well. Okay. So now this is added into this. And next thing, or otherwise, else the same thing, out is equal to out plus chr if chr is upper, if it is uppercase, make it as a lowercase. We need to make it as a lowercase. That is, if it is upper, we need to pass and make it as a lower. Just say upper. Or else, leave it as it is. Got it? And finally, this will produce out. Okay? Now I'm going to call my function. So if you call inside a function, what happened? If I call like this, what happened? So see the indentation. I mean inside a function, I'm not still went outside, still I mean inside a function. So if I execute, what will happen? Because this is the basic mistake what I the beginner actually doing. So a few of my students also did that. So what will happen if I execute?
It will go in loop.
Nothing happened because we never call the function. We are actually call inside a function, but we never call outside, right? Until you're calling outside, nothing going to execute. It is still there. Nothing executed. When you print, say, we'll get a hi, that's it. We never call the function. So when we'll call, so whenever we're calling, it's outside. Otherwise, it's still inside. So this is a definition. We never initiate a function call. This is still in function definition until indent exists. If you turn off the indent, then only it will be in a new line. Got it? Now, I'm going to fetch some result. So enter your name. I'm going to say okay. It says Kiel. Why? Any guesses? I'm getting an error. My program works fine, but still I'm getting an error.
This is not in our upper and lower.
Yeah, exactly. Because we don't have that. That's why it's raising an error. So if we input something less than ABCD, like I'm going to say ABCD. Got it? Understand? So if I say once again with everything else is capital, still contains, still changes. Now I'm going to say ABCD. Return. So it's work like capitalize. So having a string. Yes dot. Capitalized. Now you understand how capitalism works. So this is the logic behind it. How you understand? So hereafter, you're supposed to think how each and every attribute and function works. Okay. Till now, we have used the existing attribute because it is exist. But if you want to be a better programmer, you need to know what is this and how it is actually working. You need to think in that way. Otherwise, you will be dependent and you will be dependent on something. So it won't make you a better programmer. If you want to be a better programmer, you need to know what this is actually doing and how to implement it yourself. You need to start thinking like that. Have you understand what is capitalized and how it is actually working? So try to replicate ESAPR or any available other stuff. Each and everyone take something and start working on it. Is it possible, right? Anything, just it is all about your logical thinking. So this will actually improve your logical thinking. Please do practice. That's it. That is a major thing we have to do. Okay. And if you feel difficult to fill all this stuff, what do you have to do? Okay. I'll tell you a built-in function called string. Okay. Just say var of string. It contains all the upper and lower case. See upper. ASCII lower case. Or a complete case is there. So ASCII letters will contain the complete letters. Dot. It contains all the lower and upper case together. Okay. So instead of converting dictionary, is it possible to use the same one exactly? Either we can convert it into dictionary. How to convert it into dictionary? Or you can use a lowercase string dot lowercase and string dot uppercase. You will get both. Got it? Now I need to prepare upper with uppercase equivalent lowercase. How to do that? So I need to create a dictionary, right? Okay. So we all know type conversion. We can convert this into list, right? It is possible, right? Now, is it possible to convert into dictionary? Is it possible? Any guesses? Hello all, any guesses? Will it work or not? So converting into list is possible. Yeah, please. Yeah, try something. Say something. Because it is all about your thinking. So what you are actually thinking about. So if you expose, so it is better to sort out. So if you have a misunderstanding or something. Yeah. Someone try it seems. Any guesses? Will it work or not?
It will work.
It is
possible to convert into list from string because this is string, and it is possible to convert into list because both string and list are index based position, correct? So we have a value, we can place it in a list by the system will take care of it. That is 0 to 1. But here we don't have a key, right? We don't have a key. We need a key. So it contains one value, but dictionary require two values. It says has length 1, but 2 is required for each and every position. For each and every position, we need 2 inputs. So like I will show you. If I have 2 position like a comma 1, now so each index, so this is 0th index contains 2 position. Each and every index. So now this is a first position contains 2 inputs, right? 2 length. It contains the length is 2. Now it is possible to convert to dictionary. So I'm passing a list into it. See, in my list, each and every object contains 2 input. Each and every object contains 2 input. So now this is possible. Convert into dictionary. Got it? Now, similarly, how to make it into it? So So what should we keep as a key? What should we keep as a value? So shall we keep this as a value? So see, I'm going to make this is lowercase, I'm assigning to L, and uppercase I'm assigning to U. Okay, in L we are having lowercase and U we are uppercase. Now we need to make uppercase the corresponding lowercase, right? So there is a built-in function called zip. What is zip actually doing? We all using in a day-to-day life zip, right? So what zip do? As a simple mechanism which will combine both left and right end in together, right? Using its index. So what is zip actually doing? A simple mechanism. It will actually combining zeroth teeth with zeroth teeth from left side into zeroth teeth from right side. And similarly, it will merge first teeth from left side and first teeth from right side. That is zip actually works in a real life. Similarly, what zip will do? Zip will take inputs like, now I'm going to say L comma U or U comma L. So if you want to perform, if you want to do upper, you need to, what unit is it? You need to say U comma L. Got it? So this will return something like that. Use list. You will see. Now, is it possible to convert into dictionary? So we can assume this is a key, this is a value, right? So instead of converting list, just say dictionary. We'll get it. And we all know dictionary is an unordered collection. So it will be look like this, but still we have it. So we have all everything, all other, every characters are there. Understand? So I'm going to use the same one inside. Import string. Okay, so inside, instead of this, I'm going to use. So hope you understand what is zip. If you have any doubt, just please ask me. Okay, for lower, what to do? Similarly, for lower, what to do? Pardon? What to do?
It's just the opposite.
So that is L, L, and U. That's it. You will get it. Now I'm going to execute with the same input. You get it. Okay. So the logic was that you need to change something inside to make everything is upper. So hope you can try upper. So I will give you an exercise. Create upper function and lower function. Okay, what you have to do, keep this thing as it is, and here inside this logic you need to make some changes. This is your exercise. Now you need to understand what is how upper works and how lower works. I will give you an exercise. So take this as an exercise. We have 2 days time, right? Saturday, Sunday is there. Practice yourself and share with me. So it is already there. It is shared inside the drive. You will find this a function. So inside a function I implemented, okay. So similarly, as like a capitalize, what you do? Just say def upper. Start implementing. That's it. Copy paste the exact code. Copy paste this exact code. And instead, if you feel the code is repeated, just move it outside. Move it outside. Okay. Move it outside. So here we don't need to replicate. So still it works. Got it? Similarly, try to replicate the function for upper and lower as well. This is your exercise today. So is it possible? Is it simple? And this is all about a function without parameter. So example for function without, so we'll wind up with a function with parameter because you have 2 days time, without parameter. So just before we have talked about a function with parameter exercise, that is the power function and length function. I will replicate the same function with parameter. Okay, I will explain with a diff len. Okay, so we have a few more function with single argument, to a single parameter, two parameter, a lot of variations are there. Just try what you understand. So function with parameter out is equal to zero for in object out plus or equal to one return out. Okay, so this is example replicate for len. Similarly for pow, we have seen number comma power. Okay, just return number double star power. This is a replicate. Similarly, I will replicate center. How center works? Okay, how it is actually works. We all know center contains how many inputs? How many inputs center contains?
Two
inputs. Bit and fill character. And fill character is optional. Okay, I will explain the fill character with optional. If center contains two inputs, right? One is width. We need to pass some width. And second is fill character. So that is default is base. Okay, so this is the way to define a default using equal to. Equal to, if you don't define equal to, we need to pass something. If you define equal to, it contains a default, that's it. Okay, I'm going to take input, user input, okay. Now what to do? So we need to fix your width, and if your width is less than or equal to, if your width is less than your input length, okay, less than or equal to, just simply return as it is, right? We all know that. So in case I'm saying name one, so it contains three, the total length is 8, right? If I say center, my width is just center is width is 1 means written as it is. We should not convert, right? That's why, that is what I'm doing. So written input as it is. Input as it is. Or else we have to work on it. That is what to do. We need to split it into two part, right come on left. So right side is equal to width divided by 2. Got it? So say for example, if my width is 5 divided by 2, that is 2. We have to use a double slash. We don't need a floating point. Okay, so left side should be less than right side, even if it is decimal cases. That is how it works. So see, in case if I say 10, it contains exact 8. Now this is 6 character. I will create one more thing. This is 3 characters. So dot center 10. Let's check 1, 2, 3, 3. And here it contains 4 spaces. Got it? So left side should be less than, right side should be greater than. Okay. So now what I'm doing, left should be less than right, width divided by 2. Now how to create right side? Just a formula. Okay, width minus left That's it. Width is there. So if it is width is 10 and left is 5, you will get a right side. Oh, it's not width divided by 2. It works. Left is equal to len of A divided by 2. So L is, sorry, double divided by 2. That is 1. And right side should be, sorry, you have to say not len, it's width. It is width. That is 10 here. So here it is. Width minus length. So this is, here it is. Okay. Width minus. Okay, the total width, here is the formula. Width minus length, and you will get 3. Now, similarly for right side, we need a 4 as output, right? So how to do that? For right side. How to just derive the formula for right side, R is equal to the total width, that is 10, n minus length, that is 3, 7 minus lift. Here is the formula. That is, for right side, the total width, that is, if it is 10, it is 10. So here is the formula is. Len of INP. Minus len of INP. And here is the formula is width minus. Width minus len of INP minus left side. So you will get right side. Got it? And then what you need to do? You need to say, and the default fill character is there, right? So return fill character. This is the fill character star left side. Okay. And then concat, you have to apply concatenation, or we can use a string formatting method. So we need a 3 segment, right? One is left, word, and right. So what that is dot format, and the next thing is word, and the last thing is fill character into right. That's it. Okay. So here I'm done with it. Let's check. Now I'm going to check center. So if I don't pass any input, what happened? It will raise type error because your function take at least one argument. So I'm going to say 10. Okay. So once I say 10, I need to input some word. That is credo. Is it applied? Am I done? So if I say fill character, that is star it is filled. Okay, now I will give you a similar exercise. Similarly for the something related with center, we have a property called lgest and orgest, and I want you to replicate that. Okay, so similarly you have to start working on lgest exacting So I'm giving this exercise, Argist. Please start working on. So this is the four exercises I gave you today. One is upper and lower, and then Argist, Argist. Apart from that, I will give you one more built-in function for your better practice. Okay, so what to take? We have the len, got it? And Trist, str, string conversion. Str, try to replicate str built-in function. And if you can, try range. Range as well, str and range. So I gave a 2-2 for each and every segment, 2-2 for each and every segment. Replicate def range, not exactly, just a basic stuff. If we pass 10, I need 0 to 10. That's it. If we pass 20, I need 0 to 20. Don't bother about start steps in. Just start with 0 to 10. That's it. That is enough. We'll talk about in detail next class. And replicate str. Okay. This is so easy. And try to do all these 6 exercises. And we'll discuss in Monday. Any doubts? We have a lot to see. We have a lot to talk about in function. And this is a basic exercise for what we've seen till now. Got it? Any doubts?
One doubt. Previous, some steps before, we used import string, right? Why do we use import string?
It is for your purpose, right? It is hard to create alphabet, right? I already told you about import. So if you want something, it is already there. Just reuse it. Got it? In that concept, string is already there in Python. We don't need to recreate. So here, instead of recreating, it is already there. I'm reusing it. Uppercase, lowercase is there already. I'm just using it. So here, otherwise, what happened? So here, instead of using existing stuff, just create your own. Expand it. With all the 26 character, it is burden to write all the 20 character, right?
Yeah.
That is what.
So, we can do another way, like import without giving import string. If we have one character, if we assign in one variable, then that we can use .ASCII dot value lowercase. We'll be getting, right?
No, so you need to import and start using it. So this is an attribute was resided in a package called string, as like a center. Is it possible to use center without any without string? It will raise name error, right?
Mm-hmm.
It will raise name error. So we can use it with string, because this is a part of string. This is an attribute which is reside inside a string. Similarly, ASCII character and ASCII lowercase was reside inside a string. A string module. Got it? We can use it with string.
Okay.
Clear?
Yeah, fine.
So then you can start executing the remaining stuff. Okay. So we'll see in Monday. Please do all this 8 exercise, and we'll talk about we'll talk about the exercise in Monday. So I need your cooperation. Just please send me that exercise. We'll discuss in detail next class. Okay. So bye. Happy weekend. We'll see Monday.
Happy.
Any doubts? Shall we end up?
Yeah, thank you, Mohan.
Yeah, thank you, Vishya.
Thank you.
If you have anything, just please feel free to ask me. We'll see.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.
Bye, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you.